This is Steam Gambling, the segment where I, God Emperor Cole, satiate my addictions to video games and gambling in one go. I bought a random Steam key for like $2 with the intention of reviewing whatever I was given. This time I got The Secret Order 3, Ancient Times. Oh boy. The game was developed by Sunward Games, who are responsible for a big old slew of hidden object games like the Secret Order series. If you don't know what hidden object games are, think I Spy, but cyber! In this game, you play as Sarah Tissington, who's the daughter of some dude in a mystical order called the Secret Order of the Griffins. Griffin! And now, she's gotta go to the past to save the world from some mask and a scepter. Okay, maybe I'd understand a little bit better if I played the other, like, 6 games in this series. Pretty much, the story sums up as,
if I don't collect these meaningless objects, the world will end and everyone will die!
Let's talk about the game. The presentation is actually pretty good. The art is solid, and for a game that's pretty much about looking around your environment for stuff, I mean, that's pretty important. Gameplay segments are cut up by these short FMV movies that look like they were ripped straight from a PS2-era game. I mean, they're not terrible, but...
Sarah! We're trapped! It's the artifact.
Okay, they're bad. They're bad. They're really bad. No, they're bad. The actual game has you going from area to area, solving puzzles. You find and pick up stuff in the levels to solve different puzzles, and that mostly involve manipulating objects with your mouse. It's nothing groundbreaking, but for the genre, it's pretty standard. There are also various I Spy-style segments, where you look for a list of objects in a picture. Seriously, getting deja vu here. I mean, it's like I'm back in elementary school, playing I Spy under my desk while I'm trying to avoid a Duke so he doesn't steal my lunch money. My only problem with the gameplay is the skip bar that fills up at the bottom of the screen during a puzzle that'll solve it for you if you take too long to do it. I mean, it's optional to press it, but seriously, it's like giving your player the option,
hey, here's an option to skip like half our game, lol.
You can also interact with a few NPCs who...
We ma gamble a red heart and-
Okay, animation is not this game's strong suit. Neither is voice acting.
You want something inside that Bobby's box, Mom? That Bobby's a mean one, he is. You got any food to spare? Maybe some bread, Mom? Bread, Mom?
But, you know what? This actually wasn't awful. I mean, I'm not a fan of the hidden object genre, and I would never play this game on my own volition. But holy sh**, this was surprisingly passable. And for a regular $10 price tag, that was a pretty good deal for an experience I did not outright hate. So is this a jackpot or a bust? Can't believe I'm saying this, but The Secret Order 3 Ancient Times is kind of a jackpot. Did not see that one coming.